and welcome to this special episode of India Revival Mission Dialogues. And joining me today is none other than the CMD of Punjab National Bank, Mr. Rao. I want to ask you, Mr. Rao, that India has been through such a huge challenge in the pandemic days. How do we foresee getting out of this, given the fact that GDP has already been forecasted to have contracted by about 5%. We need to grow, or at least expected to grow by about 8%. Are these figures that keep coming out every day, being projected by one arm of the government or the other? Do you think these are achievable numbers? Are you beginning to see something on the ground?
Good. Before we look at for the figures, if you see, the pandemic has been very highly impacted the economy. It's not only in our country, it is a global impact. The other important thing is it was never envisaged to see the impact, how it would have been played out across the globe. So considering those factors, if you look at, yes, economy has been impacted, and the kind of prediction what they made almost a month or a couple of months back, that the economy, GDP may go into negative. The point here for all of us in the ecosystem is that we need to look at as to how we are working towards immediate revival rather than looking at the figures and bogged down with the expectation. The revival comes based on the situation, how it is improving. Now that we have seen almost 5 months of the impact in the pandemic, this month end will be the sixth month when we see that even though the cases still are growing up, but there is a change in the economy. There are green shoots appearing and there is an activity which has started. The kind of revival what we are looking at with the full impetus may not happen immediately, but it could take a couple of months more time. But we are able to see the green shoots. In the ecosystem, every vertical person, every stakeholder has a responsibility and will have to take it forward accordingly.
So as far as banks are concerned, and public sector banks at that, how do you see your role? There have been stimulus packages that have been announced by the center. The banks have to implement these on the ground. How do you see these stimulus packages? Are they practically seeing any demand on the ground? There is concern about the MSME sector, the small and medium enterprises, which suffered the most. Are you seeing the revival green shoots in specific sectors, or is there a positive story coming from across the board in MSME, large scale sectors, manufacturing, and across the country?
First thing is the role of public sector banks is very pivotal in the current situation, not only in the current situation, overall in the economy. If you have seen, once the lockdown was declared for the first time from 25th of March, the first thing what Prime Minister declared was to provide the support through DBT across all the Jan Dhan Yojana account holders. It was the public sector banks, the group of banks who have worked towards providing immediate credits to those people. So the role, if you look at, considering the position of impact of pandemic, the PSBs, public sector banks role has been very highly pronounced in providing the services. Though there were tough times for the employees to go to the branches at 100% level, though we maintained at 50% level, but the role has been continuous since then. Now if you look at the economy reviving back, except few sectors like hospitality, aviation, and tourism industry, which may take some time for coming back because of the social behavior pattern, how it is going to play out post-pandemic, all other industries we look at, that they'll be starting to come back. Now within that, high labor intensive may take some time, but low labor intensive, more technology driven business operations, they will come back very fast. We have already seen while discussing with various associations that the export orders also have started coming up. So there is a very critical role to be played by PSBs in terms of revival of our economy.
I asked you specifically, Mr. Mallikarjun Rao, about the MSME sector, because bulk of the growth, employment, as well as production will need to come in from this sector. Are you seeing, and I want you to say this absolutely clearly and in a factual manner, because when the stimulus package was announced, there was an expectation that it would do a lot for reviving the growth. Do you think the demand keeps up with that expectation, or do you think it's fallen short?
No, it's not falling short. The initiatives taken by Government of India is playing out. But before that, you kindly look at MSME has been passing through tough times, not because of COVID, but for the last couple of years. There has been issues. If you look at, even RBI came out for restructuring of MSMEs last year itself, up to 25 crores, whereupon standard advances, where the unit is running, there is a restructuring window opened by maintaining the account as standard. It was because they were passing through tough times. COVID has to a certain extent aggravated the situation. However, government has come out immediately with various measures to improve the position of the MSMEs. If you look at emergency credit with partial guarantee, we have extended to MSMEs. For the first time post-COVID, we have seen that we are able to talk to the customers directly in order to reach out to them to provide the credit. There are green shoots in the economy. There is a wonderful opportunity for MSMEs to come up. Simultaneously, Government of India has also enhanced the vertical scope of units being covered under MSME by changing the definition of MSMEs. All these measures are in right direction. We are seeing the demand, but MSMEs being the loan or the requirements are not in a critical mass to compare with the overall credit growth in the country. It may not be looking to be very high in terms of the credit growth or credit delivery. However, number of MSMEs who are coming forward are many, and we are expecting that the there will be a good amount of demand for MSMEs to come up.
So, Mr. Rao, what you are saying is the demand is sluggish. You know, we like to look at it from the bottom line perspective. Demand from MSMEs is sluggish at the moment. It is expected to pick up. And therefore, the question comes out, the criticism of the packages that have been given by the government so far is that there is no interest waiver. There is no hand holding. And in the times that these MSMEs could not operate at all for at least 3 or 4 months during the lockdown period, they have not only lost their orders, they've also lost their production time, they've lost even the finances, no earnings, so how do they repay the loans? The question really is, and that is where we come to the crux, because the recovery will actually depend on the fact whether we are addressing the real issue or are we glossing over the issue. I'm asking you, are MSMEs over the hump and now will they come back, or do they need a little deeper injection which may involve some amount of subsidies or write-offs as well?
See, first of all, I do not agree that there has been a problem in such a way that MSMEs have not been handheld. The concluding point what you mentioned is whether MSMEs will have come out of the hump or they will come back to the normalcy. I don't have any doubt to see that MSMEs will not come back. They will certainly come back. And if you have seen whatever has happened in the last few months post-COVID, there has been a lot of hand-holding done, but the fact remains that the unit has to run. In the COVID situation, the unit is not running, and they have the operational expenditure to take care. For taking care of the operational expenditure, banks have come forward in giving additional lending to them. Emergency credit line, government has come forward for the emergency credit line, 3 lakh crore they have allocated for that. 1,50,000 to 60,000 crores has already been sanctioned and disbursed to a greater extent. These are all indicative of hand holding to MSMEs without any doubt. But the question is, the operating cycle gets moving only once their sales take place. Now we are expecting that in the couple of months to happen. There would not be any issue on MSMEs because they generate the lot of employment, and there are a lot of opportunities. Even now, the government has banned certain imports from China, which are going to give more opportunity for MSMEs to take it forward, though the fructification may not happen overnight, but it is in the right direction. So I am of the opinion that while we are agreeing that MSMEs have been passing through tough times, but it is not correct to conclude that they will not have any advantage of getting the credit or handholding. Definitely banks are coming forward in the times to come, they will have opportunity. Coming back to installment payment or interest payment, moratorium has already been declared. RBI has already come out with the restructuring. So restructuring will be done for all those accounts which are eligible in the category where the units are running. So as such, the burden of repayment will be shifted over a period of time, whereby after running the unit, by coming back to the normalcy, they would be able to take care of that such kind of burden.
How do you see the demand situation? Because many people say that the lockdown, people working from home, has created some sort of a sea change in the level of demands. And it is this that could then become a reason why production and therefore the full capacity utilization of units, whether in MSME or the large sector or the small sector, may be impacted. What does your study of the market show?
Now, the only difference in demand could be the way units are functioning in terms of their operating cycle. It may undergo little amount of change, moving towards digitalization and contacting the customers not physically but through the technology, and also handling the entire operations through technology. This would be the little amount of change in the operating cycle because of the COVID, what the situation has created. However, again, I'm repeating, the demand is there, but the question of quantum of demand, which MSMEs contribute overall in the economy, where the credit growth is calculated by RBI, their contribution is very limited because the value which they carry, while the number is very huge, is not that reckonable when in terms of credit growth. If you look at whether it's 6% or 7%, in that 7% growth, the MSME growth may not be as high if you compare with the large corporate. However, in terms of the units, number of units, if you look at, there is good demand. There are some of the units who have been running well. They are not utilizing the money, waiting for the operating cycle to come back. If they utilize the money, then interest burden will increase for them. So we have seen some of them, when we have spoken to them, why you are not utilizing the money. They said, we will take it. We have the sanctions given by the banks with us, but we will take it only when the operating cycle starts. So that is the situation. So all the units will not have the difficulty. Some of them will come early. Some of them will come a little more time to come back. So we expect that the overall coming back will be from October onwards in a more effective manner. There is an animal spirit which we can see in the MSMEs for coming back to the normalcy in a very effective manner.
So you're saying the festival season in October, November will fuel the demand as well as the operating cycles, and that's when we should begin to see the change in the growth rates of the economy.
See, automobile industry, we have seen Maruti indicating that the July month has been very good for them.
How do you see the NPA issues of banks, which was an area of concern, now being impacted with the after effects of the stimulus packages and the waiver that has been given, the moratorium that has been given? In short, the health of the public sector banks themselves.
If you look at, since 2014 December, because of asset quality review which was undertaken by Reserve Bank of India, public sector banks have been passing through tough time. Tough time in terms of higher NPAs at the gross level, at the net level. But in the process of last 4 or 5 years, the PSB space has improved the provision coverage ratio. While the recoveries, still the challenges remained in terms of the resolutions in larger cases. So before COVID, many of the PSB banks have come to a situation where they were able to come out of the backlog of that AQR review. However, post-COVID, recently, if you have seen the financial stability report published by Reserve Bank of India, they have estimated that there could be a gross NPA increase at around 4%. Looking at the way the economy is moving through post-COVID and how the coming back of economy is dependent on the time frame. So we are of the opinion that there will be definitely some amount of stress on the banks overall. It is only not PSB, but every bank for that matter overall. And we concur with the viewpoints of the Reserve Bank of India, whereupon they've told in the financial stability report. However, the challenge for all of us will be to work towards how we can come out and maintain the proper balance sheet position.
Mr. Rao, even the credit growth figures that have just come out, while people are still quibbling about the real estimates, but the fact of the matter is that credit growth from private sector banks have been better than the public sector banks. Do you agree, and what's the reason for this?
No, there is no reason for me to disagree. These are all the figures which are in the public domain. What I can understand is that the business models between public sector space and private sector space a little different, to the extent that the last mile connect is pretty systematic in private sector banks with the customers, whereas in public sector banks, they fall short of that. As a result, when the opportunity is available, even under the COVID situation, they've gone more aggressively in credit delivery. While public sector has also worked towards that, probably they've gone little ahead of us. But in private sector as well, it cannot be true with every bank. There are only a couple of banks who have done better in terms of credit growth compared to others. So others are also on the same line. If you look at overall the credit and compare with the March, the growth has not been very pronounced. But we expect that from October onwards, the growth will take place.
So Mr. Rao, what you're saying is marketing, last mile connectivity with customers, is something that public sector banks will have to work on, because you yourself are saying that technology will play a huge role in the times to come, from the lessons that we've learned the COVID pandemic months. How do public sector banks plan to gear up to this? And simply the animal spirit that you're talking about is also required amongst the workforce.
Correct.
Private sector banks probably do well because there are targets that they have to meet, and we've seen from previous experience that targets in public sector banks can create a completely different animal, which is called scams. So how do you expect to resolve this?
No, first I would like to differ with the view that targets can create scams. I don't think it happens like that. The only difference here is private sector has an opportunity to choose where they want to go. Public sector is in the line of building the social requirements. So there is a paradigm different in the objectives of public sector and private sector. Public sector goes in terms of what you call social requirements and reach out to every customer. The fact that what I have mentioned about the last mile connect, there is also a difference in the PSB space now moving towards digital lending. If you look at in the lower segment in terms of MSME or in terms of retail at the lower ticket size, it is always the digital lending which takes precedence, or which takes the reach out to customers more effectively. PSB 59 initiative by Government of India, which was taken 1.5 years back, was in that right direction. Now many of the banks like State Bank of India, Bank of Baroda, Punjab National Bank, they are moving in that direction. They've already introduced. So there is no doubt, or there is no denying fact, that the digital lending or digitalization of credit delivery should be the paramount objective for the banks. When we do that, it is like a democratizing the credit delivery. Now there is no question of any institute having a larger stake. It is the one which does well in digital credit delivery which comes out as a winner. So we are working towards that. There is a need for the PSBs to go in that line. All are working towards that.
Mr. Rao, also the competition factor. For normal lay people, when you go out, people who are looking for home loans, people who are looking for vehicle loans, people who are looking for other kind of white good loans, etc., have often gone in for private sector lending simply because they are faster, they are more aggressive, they're able to market their products better, in a manner of speaking. Do you think public sector banks will also have to gear up, their customer face keeping in competition with private sector banks?
No, definitely. There is no doubt on that PSBs also have to gear up. But at the same time, PSBs also have been doing well. There are niche markets for every bank. PSB, because of the brand image, people come here, they take the loan. I do agree that turnaround time and the last mile connect are going to define the way we do the business. If you look at the vehicle loan segment, it is actually the NBFC which has taken over in the last 5 years. Not even private sector banks, though they were doing, but the predominantly NBFCs were the one who have taken vehicle loan. But for the last 1.5 years, since October 2018, when the NBFCs have been passing through tough time regarding their liquidity management and asset liability management problems, the vehicle loan got impacted. Then slowly other banks also have come. So it is a matter of economic status, which is available as a market to all the players. They have to take it forward. Now the fact remains, the turnaround time and the last mile connect. If every bank is able to adhere to this and show the consistency, definitely they can do the business. And from the PSB perspective, we are all clearly aware of that and working towards that.
Mr. Rao, moratoriums, how is that going to affect the balance sheet of the Punjab National Bank?
Moratorium is declared by Reserve Bank of India for 6 months. By August 31st, it will end. It means that demand for installment and interest will not be raised for the borrower, which is expected to be added at the end of the repayment schedule to be paid by them. So to that extent, the borrower has an advantage that the burden is not their backlog burden when he looks forward after the what you call moratorium is completed. So as a result, there is an ease for taking care of the installments from September onwards. In terms of retail, the salaried class, there is no issue. In terms of the MSME as well, once they come back to normalcy, they can move forward. If there are any issues related to them, there is a window open for undertaking the restructuring. Coming back to Punjab National Bank, initially when we have seen the moratorium availed by the people at the end of May, the percentage of the people who have availed stood almost at 30%. Whereas now, over a period of time, when the moratorium has been extended, people have become conscious that they did not want to have the burden of installment not being paid and accumulated. People started paying the money. Now, by the end of July, the percentage of people who have taken the moratorium in terms of the value has come down to almost 18 to 19%. So what we look at is, while RBI has opened a window recently with respect to restructuring, of course with certain conditions, it is a very positive what you call decision given by RBI. We will take it forward. It is a matter of identifying appropriately and taking it forward. But definitely there will be stress in the banking space related to NPA, but we have to overcome them over a period of time.
So Mr. Rao, in a way it proves the fact that I started off with asking you, which is moratorium only shifts your burden to a later date. There has been no waiver, there has been no support that has come in for the loss of time, which was not the borrower's fault. And that is where you know, the problem that we heard in the initial part was coming from MSMEs, from medium industries, small industries, even larger industries were having this problem because it wasn't their fault that they had to shut down their plants. It was really the force majeure. But all stimulus packages, all packages announced, all rules announced by RBI and public sector banks haven't really factored that in. Does that actually, realistically speaking, lead to the death of many of such units who, for whom moratorium was not the issue, survival was the issue?
No, I don't agree with that. The reason is, the even lending what we have done under the government partial guarantee scheme, the interest rate was very low. In fact, in the last 1.5 years, if you look at, by shifting to repo rate link, the interest burden has come down drastically for MSME and retail segment. Earlier it used to be hovering around 9-10%, whereas now it is hardly anything around 8% or even below 8%, 7.5% what we are giving. The fact here is that the lending money by the bank is done by taking the deposit from the public. If you are looking at a waiver of interest, whether we can waive the interest payment to the depositors, it doesn't happen like that. That is number one. Number two, time value for money, for receipt. These are all the factors in any banking business. What is very important is, while the debt burden may remain, if we are able to give easing the burden by not looking at the installment or interest payment immediately, but deferring it over a period of time, will always give an opportunity to the unit to come out of the problem and rotate their business in a proper manner for repayment, for making the repayments over a period of time. So I do see that the measures taken by Government of India through Atmanirbhar Bharat Yojana, various measures have been declared, 20 lakh crore, which includes even guarantees by Government of India, it is in the right direction. They already started showing wonderful results in the bottom place, but the results can be more effectively seen once the economy comes back, once the operating cycles come back. Some of the units started doing well, but overall units will start come back from October onwards.
So Mr. Rao, which are the sectors that you expect will lead the recovery of the economy?
There are many sectors. Logistics will come back. All the vertical manufacturing industries related to textiles, related to engineering goods, related to automobiles, they will all come back because they are already seeing the demand. And the exports which are taking place from India to Europe, to US, they are already starting. They include even textile goods. They include various other elements. As I said, only 4 or 5 sectors will get impacted, like hospitality, like tourism industry, like aviation industry, where social behavior is going to define the vertical position in the days to come or in the years to come. Remaining all industries, they are just longing for it. And the wonderful opportunity will be by restricting the imports from China, it is an opportunity for domestic industry. There are two challenges. One challenge is to match up to cost of production. Another challenge is match up to cost of sales. Cost of production, because it is very cheap in China, we have got a lot of imports being done. So when the imports are restricted, it is better that there is no other competitor in the cost of production, though there may be some requirement of providing impetus at that level for exports. Again, cost of sales or the overall cost when you sell to be in the market. There are competitors for us from Bangladesh, from Taiwan, for various textile and other goods. If we are able to remain there. Now, there also, specific to the industry, probably if government is taking care of that, the vertical things can happen more effectively. I don't see the reason why we should be looking at negatively. Yes, definitely during the year, the GDP growth may get impacted. It may not be on the lines of what we have thought of originally prior to COVID. Even post-COVID estimates, we'll have to rework on that once the economy is coming back. But it is time for every stakeholder to look forward to see that everybody comes back.
Well, we've got our fingers crossed, Mr. Rao. Any slogan that you have in mind for the months that are coming?
No, it is the revival of MSME. That is very important.
Revival of MSME. And that's why the India Revival Mission is the mission we are carrying out. What it takes to revive the economy, get it back on its feet, even as we see green shoots appearing. And tonight, the Managing Director and CEO of Punjab National Bank, Mr. S.S. Mallikarjun Rao, gave us a bird's eye view of how the Indian economy is going to be seeing green shoots in every area. The banks are geared up for the revival mission, and we hope every sector unit is going to be ready for this takeoff stage. We'll be here watching, monitoring, and coming back with inputs that you may have and suggestions that you may have for every stakeholder trying to revive the Indian economy. Thank you very much for joining me, Mr. Rao.